Get ready to enter the Thrive Time Show.
We started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, and we'll show you how to get here. We started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, now we're here.
We started from the bottom, now we're on the top. Teaching you the systems to get what we got. Colin Dixon's on the hooks, I break down the books. Z's bringing some wisdom and the good looks. As the father of five, that's why I'm a dive. So if you see my wife and kids, please tell them hi. It's the C&Z up on your radio. And now 3, 2, 1, here we go.
We started from the bottom, now we here.
Drivers 5.9, identifying the quick paying ideal and likely buyers here with the nation's best business coach, America being the nation.
See, the thing is, I want to be clear. We have a Thriver we just talked to on Skype in New Zealand.
Oh, awesome.
And when you said the nation's best, I immediately, man, because of my neutrality, my unbiased, my overall worldview that embraces the whole Brexit, you know, Britain exiting the European Union.
Yeah.
And but my still inclusiveness of the European Union and my love for other countries, I immediately defaulted to New Zealand. So when, wow, you said nation, I thought New Zealand.
Yeah.
Wow.
What's that New Zealand guy's name?
Let's not get into the specifics because when you start to do that, you
yeah, I understand.
What you do is you start to give away the anonymity.
Yeah,
you of don't the whole. Do that. No, you don't. But we can. Marshall would give away the anonymity.
Yeah.
So if, maybe ask Marshall; he'll give that away.
I'll ask him that. But
wouldn't be willing to do that.
But hello, in New Zealand, I want to visit you and all the Hobbit holes.
That's right.
So we're identifying the quick paying ideal and likely buyers.
Yeah.
Now, you did this in real estate,
and still do it in real estate,
and you currently do it in real estate.
Yeah.
But you were rocking real estate at one point. Like, you owned half of Tulsa, right?
Well, we didn't own it, but what we did is we ended up leasing. The way it works in real estate is this. You have one group over here that owns buildings or houses. And you have one group over here that's looking to buy or lease houses or buildings. So one group owns, one group is looking to buy or lease, one group is looking to sell or rent out. So it's kind of the deal.
Yeah.
So what we did, and I did not come up with this strategy. My partner and a Thrive 15 investor, Braxton Fears, did. But what he would do is he would call the building owners. I'm going to role play with you. Here we go.
Yeah.
Boop, 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 boop. Hey, who's the owner there?
That'd be me.
Okay. Well, hey, I'm driving around town here, and I noticed your building here at 91st and Yale. It seems like it has a little vacancy in it.
Yeah.
What do you have available for rent?
Oh, whole thing.
The whole thing? Okay. Well, basically, I'm with Fears and Clark Realty Group. We're a commercial real estate group. And I'm looking to I have a couple of tenants I'm working with that are looking to lease out some space.
Okay.
And I was just curious if you had anything available that would work for an office with about 6 employees.
Actually, I do.
Okay. Well, hey, and then we meet.
Yeah.
And the whole goal is to set an appointment with you as the owner and then to find out if you'd be willing to get us to market your property for you. Instead of you marketing it, because you're the owner, but you're not good at marketing the building. You own multiple businesses or you're busy, so you're not, that's not what you do.
Right.
We will market it for you. So then the pitch is this. All right, so here we go. So, Josh, question, how come you're deciding to market the building yourself?
I want to save some money.
Okay, here's the deal. I won't make you sign a listing agreement, but we will get you to the top of Google. We do drone videography. We do photography. We do the whole marketing blitz. Awesome flyers. We put it on MLS. We put it on all the commercial listings. So we make our phone rings all the time, and we get paid. You pay us 6% of whatever the person pays when they lease the building. So if the lease is $1,000 a month, then we end up making a commission of basically $60 for each one of those months. And so if it's a 5-year lease, right, and the total value of the lease is $60,000,
mm-hmm,
then you would owe us 6% of the $60,000 when they pay you.
Wow.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Boom. And so we would go around doing this. And so we ended up getting a deal where we ended up working with Maurice Kanbar, who invented Sky Vodka, and we represented 1/3 of downtown Tulsa.
Wow,
but
that's
Braxton,
a fun fact.
Yeah, it's a fun factoid. But also, and you can, we'll put the little link on the screen so people can check it out. But we ended up selling a building called the Bridgeport Building.
Mm-hmm.
It was like, I want to say a $3 million building. We did a big lease with O'Reilly's. Braxton helped team up with do a deal that brought the Coca-Cola to an abandoned mall. You know, the Eastland Mall.
Yeah, I used to love that mall.
Okay, well, that mall ended up not being very financially viable over the long haul.
Yeah.
And Braxton was able to lease that out to Coca-Cola into a mega call center.
Wow.
We did some deals with, not Barnes & Noble. What's the one that went out of business? Borders.
Borders.
Borders went out of business. But we worked with Borders. We helped them lease out their buildings when they were shutting down the store. And that's what we did. And but the thing is, most people in commercial real estate go broke because they're trying to lease out their buildings. They're trying to focus on long-term deals. So remember, people who are looking to lease a building are in much larger abundance. There's much more of people who are looking to rent a building for their business than people who are looking to buy one.
Right.
So we would then, while we were calling owners, another group of our team would be calling business owners. And here's the call for that. Boop, 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 boop. Hey, is this the owner of the Smoothie King?
This is he.
Hi, my name is Clay Clark with Fears and Clark Realty Group. How are you?
I'm so good, just making some smoothies.
Oh, beautiful. Well, hey, here's the deal. When does your lease expire?
This May.
Okay. And most people, by the way, have like a 3-year or 5-year lease.
In a couple years.
So I'd say, no, it's fine. I mean, most people have a 3-year or 5, and you don't know if it's going to expire right now or in a few months. But anyway, so I'm hopping back into it. So your lease expires here in May, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, here's the deal. Have you ever thought about looking for a different location where you could maybe pay a little less rent or maybe get a little better build out? Or
you're talking my language.
Well, we have a team of ours that we represent tons of properties in Tulsa, and I could potentially find you a better building that you could lease at a better rate or with a better build out or better visibility or more street traffic, that kind of thing. When would be a good time to meet you and I could show you all the properties we have available?
Why don't you come get a smoothie down here?
I will come get a smoothie. And then after I come get the Incredible Hulk smoothie with an extra scoop of protein and a little bit of whey protein, and then a little bit of Energizer and a little bit of a fish oil extract that we want to add to that, then I want to go ahead and I'd like to show you some properties and we can see if we can help you. So we had one team here calling business owners that are looking to lease, right?
Yeah.
Asking them when their lease expires. And another team over here calling the owners to see if they were looking to lease the space. We had a massive whiteboard and we would try to tie the two together.
Love it.
And we're the middlemen, okay? But we made money because we were always on the phone with people who were, we were only talking to people who really did want to lease space, and we would track it, Josh, so we'd only be talking to people whose leases were expiring soon.
Yeah.
So if your lease expired in 6 months, we would put it on the board and we'd call you in 6 months. And so, but most people in commercial real estate are running around talking to people who, I might want to buy a building. Okay, right. Well, when are you going to buy it? Well, it could be in the fall. I don't know. If you're a multimillionaire, most multimillionaires are not irrational and they don't act very quickly. They're very methodical. So they say, well, I might want to buy it in the fall of 2018. In 4 years?
Right.
Yes, after I get the liquidity back up in our third business. Okay, so you want to buy?
Yes, I do.
Are you soon?
Absolutely.
When again?
2018, probably 2019.
You know, and so you die on the vine running around chasing these people, or you're running around dealing with a guy who's frankly just delusional. These business owners who are like, yeah, we're a startup. So what do you guys do? We do interior design and we do eco-friendly cleaning and we do a whole lot of, we detail cars. So your eco-friendly interior design, well, it's really an offshoot of what we call an LLC, which is part of our grand vision to build a community of people who are working together for the cause of sharing the word.
Yeah.
So it's a ministry. Well, if you look at it that way, but really we're trying to sell detailing for cars for interior design because my wife, really, she's going through a transition, and so could we see some spaces? And I'm not kidding. That's what we would spend our day. And you have to decide, is the guy I'm on the phone with, is he drunk? Is he real? So you want to focus on people who are going to buy soon.
Yeah.
Soon.
Quick paying.
Because you have to pay bills now.
Boom. And listen, if you want to learn more about Clay's deep dive into the world of commercial real estate, we're going to put a link on the screen. You can go to that.
Yeah.
And you can find out and read all about it. It's a good read.
And if you want to right now, you're saying right now, we'll put a link on the screen to Sprick Realty.
Ooh.
If you live in Tulsa and you want to sell that house, I mean, this is the deal where a lot of times people, they accuse me, they say, I feel like you're always trying to sell me something. Like you're just, You're always trying to do high pressure. If you ever feel, right now, let those alarms go off because I am. Yeah. Just get up there to that Sprick Realty site, find out how great we are, and have us list your house, have us sell your house. And what's going to happen is you're going to make lots of money from selling your house. And if you're in a bad spot where you're like, I don't have a whole lot of equity here, we'll list your house at such a great rate, such a great deal. You're going to go, why didn't I do that before? Because we're going to bring the swag.
Clay's such a good salesman. When he's selling me something, it's a hypnotizing thing. I tend to glaze over, and then I just say yes.
Put your house on the market. Don't talk to your wife. Just put it on the market. It brings marriages together. When you sell your house without your wife's permission, it brings families together when you're sleeping alone.
Yes, Clay. That's what it does to me.
Okay.
All right. Listen, if you run a business that sells products and services to other businesses, you can quickly identify who your ideal and likely buyers are by filling out this following worksheet, these following questions.
Yes, do it.
All right. The gender of your ideal and likely buyers.
I hate to say it, but most of the people who are signing leases are business owners. You hate to say that? Why'd you hate to say it? Well, because the majority of business owners in our particular market, because of the kind of buildings we focused on, tended to be males. That's so sexist. Well, if we had, let's say you had $10 to spend on mailers, would you mail to males or would you mail to females? If 8 out of 10 of your ideal and likely buyers are males.
Right.
So,
you're just going with analytics here.
Well, yeah, and you're going, I don't like that example. That example was rude and it was mean, it was offensive. Okay, fine. So let's do this. For the rest of this training, we're gonna be better than that. We're better than that. We are gonna focus on Victoria's Secret.
Hey.
So here we go. So if I own a Victoria's Secret and I am the guru in charge, who do we mail to? Men or women? And if you're watching this and you're like, I get those catalogs too. And stop it. What we're talking about is that you'd mail to women, right?
Yes.
That's clearly your ideal and likely buyer. Let's move on.
All right. The next thing you want to do is the age of your ideal and likely buyers.
I don't know that people who are like in their 80s who are going, hello, what? Hey, let's go to Victor's Secret. It's Victoria's Secret. Yeah, I like Victor. What does it say? I got a mailer and it looks to be flesh colored. We should go in there, Margaret. I mean, I just don't know that's going to be really the niche.
Right.
Really, people who go to Victoria's Secret are what? Unfortunately, it's girls who are like 18, 16, 17, 18 to like 60?
Sure.
50? I don't know when people stop caring, but I think at a certain point when you're like 85, right. I can't even see myself, let alone know what I look like. Forget it. You know what I mean? There's a certain age where you just aren't naked anymore. You never get naked.
Awesome.
I'm just saying. You never want to... Because really what Victoria's Secret is it's like a decorative naked.
That's true. That is true. The next thing you want to identify is the publications that your ideal and likely buyers consume.
So are the people who buy stuff at Victoria's Secret, are they reading Us Weekly? Are they reading Home and Garden? Are they reading... What magazines are they reading? But they're not going to probably read like... Look, I was reading Gerontology today, and when I discovered... Oh, it's upside down. Look, I was reading this new publication on the retiling late, and I discovered this ad here on the site for Victor's Secret, and... I guess we just gotta fax something on the iPod, and pretty soon the email will come in and we'll be able to head right over. Margaret, are you there? Hello, Margaret. Why do you always walk out of the room when I'm talking? I mean, that's just not your publication. You wanna think about, seriously, Victoria's Secret is a great company, but do you get mailers?
Yeah.
Because somebody in your family has gone in to buy from there before, and they just keep mailing you. They keep mailing you. They know your ideal and likely buyers, but they do not waste their time mailing to the non-ideal and likely buyers. And a quick rabbit trail. Have you started receiving the American Girl doll mailers yet?
I have not.
Dude, if you have a daughter?
Not yet.
Okay, when you have a daughter, what's going to happen is you're going to start getting these American Girl doll mailers. My son, he's in the studio today. He knows about this. They start mailing you when you're like, when you have like a one-year-old daughter, they start mailing. And my daughter, before she could even like, before she was like five, she said, I want American Girl dolls. I want one. And how do you know? You don't leave the house. You have no friends. You're not, I don't, how is this possible? I love the stories, Dad. How do you know about this? Because they're mailing. They find out when the beautiful babies are born, and they start mailing the babies.
Dark magic.
Dark magic. So again, going back to Victoria's Secret, you know, think about that. The publications. Who are, if you were the head of Victoria's Secret, what are the publications, the magazines that you that are consumed by your ideal and likely buyers?
Right. All right. We'll finish the rest of this list in our next session. Thrive on for now. Thrivers, we are back with 5.9. Identify the quick paying ideal and likely buyers. Here with America's top business coach, Clay Clark.
And I also consider myself to be one of the elite man bear pigs of our time.
Oh, my goodness.
Of all of the man bear pigs, I'm in the top echelon.
Man bear pig.
Yeah, I sit at the I sit atop of the platform of man bear pigdom, and I look down upon other man bear pigs, and I say, oh, no, you are number two or three, buddy.
Boom.
Yes.
Well, right now we are in the middle of the list, all right, of identifying our quick paying ideal and likely buyers. This is the way to do it, all right? We're going to look, we're going to get right into it. We're going to look at the industry or industries that your target market is involved in.
So if you're working with companies, you would think about the industry that they're involved in and maybe what associations are they a part of or what trade organizations, what chambers of commerce or associations do they fellowship with. Now, if you're focusing on like pastors, they maybe go to a certain denomination, they go to certain conferences, but the Victoria's Secret thing, you'd look and go, what industry or industries do they, does our market, well, they buy a lot of stuff from Whole Foods. They buy a lot of stuff from Starbucks. And then you want to market there.
Yeah. Okay. The next one is the number of employees who work for your average ideal and likely buyer.
Now, if we have the Victoria's Secret, mindset here, or if we have that perspective there, they probably don't have, the average person who shops at Victoria's Secret probably has a lot of employees or no employees, or there's probably very little commonality. I would say more often than not, though, I don't know their demographics, but I would assume that most people who shop at Victoria's Secret often do not have any employees.
Yeah.
So you'd probably want to, again, focus on consumers and not, I mean, think about the insanity of this, but this is the kind of stupid stuff I've done in my career. Don't do this, because I've done these dumb things. You don't want to like mass mail a company. Could you imagine sending Victoria's Secret catalogs to the HR director going, yeah, I was calling on behalf of Victoria's Secret, following up, make sure you got the mailer. Josh, did you get the mailer?
Yeah, we did.
Well, I wanted to know, because you're the HR director, I wanted to see if you'd be willing to share the whole, Victoria's Secret catalog with the female employees. You'd put that up on the board, the job board. You put that in the mailboxes, the cubbies. Perhaps send out an email. I want to make sure that all the ladies know about these fine, fine specials. I'd be happy to come in and do a seminar to talk to all the ladies who are the ideal and likely buyers.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Could you organize all the ladies that would be likely to wear the clothing so that I could meet them and determine what's the best kind for each woman?
Yeah, I'm going to hang up now.
Is there any way? So what you're saying is you want to do an HR luncheon?
No, thank you. No, thank you.
I'll bring some kale.
Okay.
Anyway, move on.
Rare form today. Okay, the next thing you want to look at is the geographic locations of your ideal and likely buyers.
So again, where do they live? I mean, what's the home value? Again, the average home, this is my theory. I have a kind of a theory on this. If you're willing to pay extra for underwear that has the word pink on the back of it, that's with like rhinestones, and it's reasonable to spend $13 on a pair of underwear, you're probably not somebody who's living in the projects.
Yeah.
And I, having grown up with, limited financial means, I can say that's not like that. You're going, I'm hungry. I'm so hungry. No, let's not eat. Let's go buy $13 underwear.
Right.
That's not the mindset. You're going to buy, take care of your needs first, then you're going to focus on, the exclusive underwear. Once you've reached the pinnacle of life, you start to go, I want my undergarments to be awesome.
Boom. And the next thing you're looking at is the job title of your ideal and likely buyers.
Again, if you're mailing B2B, business to business, you'd work, if you're marketing business to business, this would apply more. Again, if you're marketing from the Victoria's Secret perspective, probably not going to, you know, mail to the, you know, dearest president of the company. We are trying to market to the ladies who work. No, you're not going to do that.
Right.
So it doesn't apply in that particular case.
The connections, networks, and key industry influencers who interact with your ideal and likely buyers.
Victoria's Secret example wouldn't apply here, but if let's say that for the real estate that Braxton and I did, man, there are some neat organizations out there, like the local chambers of commerce. They know all of the, not all, but they know almost all of the business owners in terms of they know, like if you were to go to the Tulsa Chamber of Commerce, you could quickly find out anybody who has 20 employees or more,
yeah,
or 200 employees or more. Well, some of the buildings we were marketing, bro, were massive. We'll put some images up on the screen here.
Love to see it.
Or you can find it by Googling Canbar Properties and then my name, Clay Clark. You can see some of these images. But the guy owned a third of downtown Tulsa. So he owned the First Place Tower, which is a massive tower. It's kind of like Tulsa's slice of Manhattan. He owned the Bank of America Tower. He just wow. owned all these buildings. And so if you're going to, you don't want to market to a guy with 10 employees or less and try to market the entire upper floor. Have you seen downtown now? Some of the buildings are lit up at night.
Yeah.
There's a new gas company. It's a oil and it's like a natural gas company that's now leasing the top floor. Have you noticed that light up at night downtown? Mm-hmm. I can't remember the name of that company, but that's the kind of company who would lease out the top floor of a business.
Yeah.
Or the top floor of a huge building. Very few people are going to lease out the top floor and pay $40,000 a month for space that would accommodate 200 people and they only have 4 employees.
Right.
So you wouldn't want to be targeting Smoothie King and going, so you guys get a lot of walk-through traffic, a lot of walk-in? Okay, yeah. So you guys need a lot of road frontage, you need a lot of traffic where people can see your signage? Why don't we put you at the top of the tower and put you at the very top so that you can look down upon everyone and judge them for not finding your smoothies?
Right.
So you just got to think about that. What are the trade associations, the connections, the networks? Who do they know that you want to get in front of? And we really did well by reaching out to a lot of these networks, associations, and chambers, that kind of thing.
The next thing we're going to look at is the social circle of your ideal and likely buyers.
Okay. And again, with the Victoria's Secret hat, it doesn't apply as much. But if you own a small business and you're trying to market to other people or you're trying to raise capital, think about the people that you want to get in touch with. Who do they know? So it's probably a dirty move, but it's fine. I wanted to get in touch with you because we were going to the church that you were the funny man at.
Yeah.
So we'd go to church, and at Church on the Move, we're sitting in the audience, and there you are. And I knew right there that you had no idea who I was because the lights are shining on you and you're focused on comedy and you have no idea who I am. But I had this connection. Now, you didn't connect. I knew right then that some point this moment would happen.
Wow.
But I didn't know how to get a hold of you because I don't really interact with people at church. And so I'm there just kind of there. So I reached out to someone I knew who I know would know you. And so I said, hey, I want to get in touch with Chris and Josh. And so I reached out to Steve Arruda.
Oh, wow.
The Groove Buddha, a.k.a. The Raven. Ka-ka!
Boo!
Steve was a guy who did some sound with Church on the Move for a while, and he was one of our first DJs.
Awesome.
And so Steve said, oh, this is the number. So I got a hold of Josh. Boop, 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 boop. Talked to first Chris, and then Chris got me in touch with you, and then we built the band. Really, what we're doing is it's like the Blues Brothers. We had to get the band together.
Right.
So anyway, that's why I'm currently, that's how you do it though. So I couldn't reach you. I didn't have your number, but I had to reach out to someone who knew you.
Yeah.
So be thinking about that. And one great way to determine that is if you go onto LinkedIn, they actually have visuals that will show you who's connected to the people that you need to know. It's kind of a cool feature.
I love that.
LinkedIn, controlling the world.
I everyone invites me to LinkedIn and I say no, thank you.
Really?
Yeah, but you shouldn't do that.
No, and I'll tell you this. I honestly haven't responded to or checked a LinkedIn message in years.
Right.
Sorry.
I don't do social media either.
I don't understand it.
Yeah. I mean, I understand it, I think, but I don't want to be a part of it.
Maybe I don't understand being a part of it.
I get that.
I have, like, I'll go in there because if I'm at a speaking event and you're like, hey, let's be LinkedIn buddies, you know, I've decided that that's the red dot that I'll do.
Yeah.
And I'll go, how many people do you know that I know? And if you know like 10 people that I know that you know, then I'll go, okay, accept. It's basically my move.
Right.
And then on Facebook, if it's a request, I'm like, accept. But if it's like a message, I don't respond to it. What's really funny is I responded to it about a year. I was about 2 years after. I went in there, hadn't said, looked on there at all for 2 years.
Yeah.
And I went in, and some of the messages were crazy urgent. Some were not urgent at all. And it was kind of funny responding to urgent messages 2 years later. It was almost funny at that point.
I love it. I do Instagram.
You do?
So I can just like say, hey.
Yeah, awesome.
Here's a picture. But it's a private account. You know how it is.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
And then the last thing is the schools that the children of your ideal and likely buyers attend.
Again, if you're in real estate, that's huge for us in real estate, just so we're clear on that, is that people who are wealthy, if you had a company that marketed products to, we have one company I work with right now that does organic dog food.
Awesome.
Like gourmet organic, bro.
Lobster.
No, this is what it is. We're talking about lobster, like organic. I mean, it's like expensive, really, really nice food that's for a dog.
But you would eat it. It's that good.
I would eat it. Yeah, I would eat it. I have no standards, but I would do it. But anyway, so like the kids who, these people have kids, their kids all go to, you know, private, very exclusive schools. Schools where people go, it's $20,000 a year to send your kid to the prestigious yada yada.
Right.
Founded in 1830, where we have a history of 170 years. They have like the row team. I mean, you know what I mean? They have their own lake.
Yeah.
Seriously, one school created their own lake, I can think of right now, to the row team. We're going to, and I remember talking to one of these parents and I said, hey, so, because my daughter was doing a ballet and we, a ballet performance, and we had to go to the school where the performance was held.
Yeah.
And I'm talking to one of the parents. I said, so what did you guys do last weekend? Just small talk? And the guy goes, well, we went up to Nantucket for the, I'm not kidding, went to Nantucket for the rowing event. You know, we got back there. Now we're going up to Canada next month. My son's competing in a basketball tournament. You're like, really? I mean, that's what they're doing. So, I mean, what I'm saying is if you're going to try to market to certain ideal and likely buyers, why not market to the PTA? So what I did is I helped a real estate agent do this years ago.
Yeah.
They did a deal where every time they sold a house, they would donate $1,000 back to the PTA.
Hello.
And so the PTA of this very wealthy school, all the houses are $1 million, $600,000, all the homes that are owned by the members of the PTA, these moms.
Yeah.
Who are highly involved in the PTA. They're like, this man, he will give us $1,000 if we list. I mean, we're going to sell our house anyway. Why not use this man?
Right.
He's here to help us. And so, no exaggeration, people just started using this realtor. And, you know, all of a sudden, he was the realtor, like, of choice for that group. Pretty awesome.
I love it. Now, we have got another list here.
Okay.
And this is if you run a business that sells products and services direct to consumers.
Victoria's Secret.
Yeah. So there's a couple different ones here, but we'll go through them again.
Let's do it.
The gender of your ideal and likely buyers again.
Yep. Same thing.
Yep. Age of your ideal and likely buyers. Okay.
Determine their age.
Yep. The publications that your ideal and likely buyers consume.
Again, if you're doing business to consumer, same process.
The hobbies of your ideal and likely buyers.
Now, that's interesting because what you'll do is like women who shop at Victoria's Secret, I'm going to argue that many of them go to yoga.
Yep.
Or at least they wear yoga pants in the and just in case a yoga event breaks out somewhere.
Right.
So they could be just going through life, look, I'm at Whole Foods, I'm getting some kale, and all of a sudden, Karen, do you hear that? I do hear it. I don't know. Abigail, do you hear that? I do hear it. It's time for yoga. Impromptu yoga. Oh, I can't do it right now because I'm not ready. But I am. I have my Lululemon yoga pants on. I could do it right now. And that's just, I mean, it's just, so people, their hobbies, you know, the yoga hobby, the fitness hobby, the whole, that hobby, that jazzercise, workout, Zumba, that hobby is the same hobby as somebody who's buying Victoria's Secret underwear. It's the same people. Think about right. Your ideal and likely buyers and what are their hobbies.
Right.
Yep.
For me, I like making videos and a videographer. And so if I see an ad with a camera in it, my eyes like instantly like, whoa, what's this?
What right now what's is the about? Hottest camera out there right now that you are looking at and you're going, oh, just if I, ooh, that thing, that lens, that camera, that whatever, that thing right now is sick. What is it?
The camera, there's some good Blackmagic cameras, 4K.
Really?
And this like nice little cinema one would be real nice.
How much are those things?
Those were like $5,000, $4,000, $5,000.
Wow.
Then there's like a full frame Canon 5D Mark II.
That when you say
Mark III? Sorry.
When you say 5,000, is it like an old English reference? Like
5,000. I like to say five. This is
henceforth 5,000.
That's how I deal with thousands. I just say thou.
Makes it seem smaller. All right. Awesome.
The next thing is the stores and online retailers routinely visited by your ideal and likely buyers.
Now, that's pretty cool because online, we're going to teach you in future episodes how to do this, or you can just go in the search bar and find the trainings.
Love it.
But check it out, dude. Like, if you are, it gets me excited. But if you are, let's say that you sell, here we go. Let's say you sell microphones and you sell cameras, that what you just mentioned. Yeah. You sell those lenses and those various things. People read blogs about cinematography 101, how to become the world's best videographer. Cool. Is there a blog that you read that's all about how to be a funny man or how to make videos or is there a blog that's hot sauce?
No.
Okay.
Is there sorry.
No. But let's just say there was, though.
Yeah.
You could make sure that your online ads show up on that website.
Yeah.
Pretty cool. So you can like make sure that your ads are shown to people who are on the podcast, the blogs, the websites of your ideal and likely buyers. That is sick.
What I do, what I'm noticing now is with Amazon, like I'll search for something.
Oh, yeah.
And then audible.com, the great book resource. And then I'm on a website and I see, I go to a different website. And then all of a sudden that same book appears that I looked at. And I'm like, hey, I want that book. Ooh. I need that hat. Ooh. They're everywhere. And it's that reinforcement. Like, okay, I better buy that.
That's why Britain did the Brexit.
Yeah.
Because of that Amazon ad. I'm just kidding. No, but the whole thing is, like, I'm just telling you, and somebody who doesn't know what Brexit is, Britain just exited the European Union.
Yeah.
But all I'm saying is what happens is, I mean, literally because of the data that people can collect, here's a fun one for you. Go to ESPN right now. Will you do it right now?
Yeah.
Go to ESPN right now. Look at the bottom left of the screen when you hit enter and look at them put the cookies all over your browser. We'll do a screenshot of this, Thrivers. But look at them put all the cookies. You see the very, very, very bottom left of the screen when you hit enter? It shows all that stuff. It shows it's processing. And if you hit refresh again, you just look at the bottom left, you'll see it. And it's loading all these cookies, all this data onto your browser. And then it just follows you around until the end of time. And the only way to make it go away is to basically just delete your cookies. And it just keeps happening. So if you go to ESPN, they put that on there. Now, if you go to like Fox News or Forbes or whatever, now you have a higher likelihood to see those ESPN ads because it follows you around the internet.
Yeah. I don't wonder why they called them cookies. That's so weird. Okay, the next thing, the net worth of your ideal and likely buyers.
I know why it's called a cookie.
Okay, go ahead. Because you leave crumbs?
I think what it is no, seriously, I think it has to do with, this is my thought process.
Sure.
Is that something you want? We all want a cookie. But then basically what happens is you want that cookie. But then you're like, I'm not going to eat the cookie because it's 3 a.m, you know? And then you know how it is as a dad?
Yeah.
This is what happens. The kids, how old is your oldest now?
Two.
You have one child is two?
Yeah.
And it's a dude.
He is.
So he wakes up. Do you and your wife take shifts, or are you the only one who watches? Or does she stay up at night, or do you stay up at night?
Oh, we shift.
Okay. So you're like, you haven't slept. The kid just keeps going, rah! And then as soon as you fall asleep, the kid looks around and goes, the kid, by the way, can secretly talk.
Yeah.
And he goes, it'd be hilarious if I wake up again right now because he just went back to sleep. And it's the baby boss. He's in charge of your life.
Right.
So what happens is then you put the kid back down to bed, and now you go downstairs, and you're like, I need some satisfaction. And you walk around, and you see some cookies that your wife made, and you're like, I shouldn't. I am not going to eat this cookie. Right? You want the cookie.
Yeah.
So you go back to bed. But these crumbs now follow you around the internet going, you want this cookie. And you just smell it. You go to a different site, you smell it, you keep seeing little cookie crumbs, and finally you're like, I just want that cookie, and you eat it.
Boom.
That's what it is.
Cookies.
Boom.
Okay, we're gonna boom right through these next ones.
Let's do it. Let's go fast. Fast.
The net worth of your ideal and likely buyers.
Yeah, basically you want to make sure that you're marketing to people who can afford what you are selling. If it's Victoria's Secret, don't market to people who can't afford it.
The value of the home of your ideal and likely buyers.
Again, you can determine somebody's home through a lot of online marketing tools, and we'll teach you how on Thrive15.com. But the main thing is you do not want to market to people who cannot afford what you're selling.
The geographic locations of your ideal and likely buyers.
Again, you want to make sure you're marketing to people in places. So specifically in Oklahoma, there are parts of Oklahoma that are known for having huge amounts of gun sales. And that's where you'd want to run. You'd want to run ads and do mailers for your gun sales in rural communities where that was, those would be appreciated. You would not want to do those same mailers to areas that are known to be historically liberal and suburban.
The job title of your ideal and likely buyers.
Again, just make sure not mailing to the wrong people. Mail to the right job title.
The connection networks and key industry influencers who interact with your ideal and likely buyers.
Well said. We're moving on.
The social circle of your ideal and likely buyers.
Just do not mail to people and market to people and get to connect with people who are not your ideal and likely buyers. Get into that group. And if you're trying to reach somebody who you don't know, ask yourself, who do they know?
Yep. And again, the schools that your children of the ideal and likely buyers attend.
Boom. We talked about it, so boom.
Yeah. So fill out those worksheets, figure that stuff out. It's all good.
It's huge.
It's all good. And here's the thing, is that you don't want to waste any time or energy on things that will not help you. You want to hit the exact market that you want to hit.
Just last Monday, I talked to a thriver, and we helped her save a little over $2,000 a month.
Awesome.
Because she had been doing mailers that were going out, and they were in a local newspaper, and they were being marketed to the whole city. And after looking at it, we determined that the people receiving her mailers were not her ideal and likely buyers.
That's awesome. You don't have time to be politically correct here.
You don't. You just got to focus on your ideal and likely buyers, and no one's going to care about it more than you.
You don't want to waste a single dollar, guys. That's what we're trying to help you do. So find those ideal and likely buyers. Again, wonderful knowledge.
You don't want to waste a few thou.
A few thou. Thrive on.
Few thou, henceforth I. JT, do you know what time it is?
4:10.
It's Tebow time in Tulsa, Jerusalem, baby. Tim Tebow is coming to Tulsa, Oklahoma, June 27th and 28th. We've been doing business conferences here since 2005. I've been hosting business conferences since 2005. What year were you born?
1995.
Dude, I've been hosting business conferences since you were 10 years old, but I've never had the two-time Heisman Award-winning Tim Tebow come present. And a lot of people, you know, have followed Tim Tebow's football career on the field. And off the field. And off the field, the guy's been just as successful as he has been on the field. Now, the big question is, JT, how does he do it?
Well, they're going to have to come and find out because I don't know.
Well, I'm just saying, Tim Tebow's going to teach us how he organizes his day, how he organizes his life, how he's proactive with his faith, his family, his finances. He's going to walk us through his mindset that he brings into the gym, into business. It is going to be a blasty blast in Tulsa, Jerusalem. Also, this is the first Thrive Time Show event that we've had where we're going to have a man who has built a $100 million net worth.
Wow.
Who'll be presenting. Now, we've had a couple presenters that have had a $1 billion net worth in some like real estate sort of things.
Yeah.
But this is the first time we've had a guy who's built a service business, and he's built over $100 million net worth in the service business. It's the yacht driving, multi-state living guru of franchising. Peter Taunton will be in the house. This is the founder of Snap Fitness, the guy behind 9-Round Boxing. He's going to be here in Tulsa, Jerusalem, Oklahoma, June 27th and 28th. JT, why should everybody want to hear what Peter Taunton has to say?
Oh, because he's incredible. He's just a fountain of knowledge. He is awesome. He has inspired me listening to him talk. And not only that, he also has, he practices what he teaches. So he's a real teacher. He's not a fake teacher like business school teachers. So you got to come learn from him.
Also, let me tell you this, folks. I don't want to get this wrong, because if I get it wrong, someone's going to say, you screwed that up, buddy. So Michael Levine, this is Michael Levine. He's going to be coming. You say, who's Michael Levine? I don't want to get this wrong. This is the PR consultant of choice for Michael Jackson, for Prince, for Nike, for Charlton Heston, for Nancy Kerrigan, 34 Grammy Award winners, 43 New York Times bestselling authors he's represented, including pretty much everybody you know who's been a super celebrity. This is Michael Levine, a good friend of mine. He's going to come and talk to you about personal branding and the mindset needed to be super successful. The lineup will continue to grow. We have hit Christian recording artist Colton Dixon in the house. Now, people say, Colton Dixon's in the house? Yes, Colton Dixon's in the house. So if you like top 40 Christian music, Colton Dixon's going to be in the house performing. The lineup will continue to grow each and every day. We're going to add more and more speakers to this all-star lineup. But I encourage everybody out there today, get those tickets today. Go to ThriveTimeShow.com. Again, that's ThriveTimeShow.com. And some people might be saying, well, how do I do it? What do I do? How does it work? You just go to ThriveTimeShow.com. Let's go there now. We're feeling the flow. We're going to ThriveTimeShow.com. Again, you just go to ThriveTimeShow.com. You click on the business conferences button, and you click on the request tickets button right there. The way I do our conferences is we tell people it's $250 to get a ticket.
Yep.
Or whatever price that you could afford. And the reason why I do that is I grew up without money. JT, you're in the process of building a super successful company. Did you start out with $1 million in the bank account?
No, I did not. Nope. Did not get any loans, nothing like that. Did not get an inheritance from parents or anything like that. I had to work for it. And I'm super grateful I came to a business conference. That's actually how I met you, met Peter Taunton. I met all these people.
So if you're out there today and you want to come to our workshop, again, you just got to go to thrivetimeshow.com. You might say, well, when's it going to be? June 27th and 28th. You might say, well, who's speaking? We already covered that. You might say, where's it going to be? It's going to be in Tulsa, Rusalem, Oklahoma. And someone says, Tulsa, Rusalem. I'm really trying to rebrand Tulsa as Tulsa, Rusalem, sort of like the Jerusalem of America. But if you type in Thrive Time Show and Jinx, you can get a sneak peek or a look at our office facility. This is what it looks like. This is where you're headed. It's going to be a blasty blast. You can look inside, see the facility. We're going to have hundreds of entrepreneurs here. It is going to be packed. Now, for this particular event, folks, the seating is always limited because my facility isn't a limitless convention center. You're coming to my actual home office, and so it's going to be packed. So when June 27th and 28th, you're going to come. I'm talking to you. You can just get your tickets right now at thrivetimeshow.com. And again, you can name your price. We tell people it's $250 or whatever price you can afford. And we do have some select VIP tickets, which gives you an access to meet some of the speakers and those sorts of things. And those tickets are $500. It's a 2-day interactive business workshop, over 20 hours of business training. We're going to give you a copy of my newest book, The Millionaire's Guide to Becoming Sustainably Rich. You're going to leave with a workbook. You're going to leave with everything you need to know to start and grow a super successful company. It's practical, it's actionable, and it's Tebow time right here in Tulsa, Jerusalem. Get those tickets today at thrivetimeshow.com. Again, that's thrivetimeshow.com.
Hello, I'm Michael Levine, and I'm talking to you right now from the center of Hollywood, California, where I have represented, over the last 35 years, 58 Academy Award winners, 34 Grammy Award winners, 43 New York Times bestsellers. I've represented a lot of major stars, and I've worked with a lot of major companies. And I think I've learned a few things about what makes them work and what makes them not work. Now, why would a man living in Hollywood, California, in the beautiful sunny weather of LA, come to Tulsa? Because last year I did it, and it was damn exciting. Clay Clark has put together an exceptional presentation, really life-changing, and I'm looking forward to seeing you then. I'm Michael Levine. I'll see you in Tulsa.
James, did I tell you my good friend John Lee Dumas is also joining us at the in-person 2-day interactive Thrive Time Show business workshop? That Tim Tebow and that Michael Levine will be at. Have I told you this?
You have not told me that.
Oh, he's coming all the way from Puerto Rico. This is John Lee Dumas, the host of the chart-topping EOFire.com podcast. He's absolutely a living legend. This guy started a podcast after wrapping up his service in the United States military. And he started recording this podcast daily in his home, to the point where he started interviewing big time folks like Gary Vaynerchuk, like Tony Robbins. And he just kept interviewing bigger and bigger names, putting out shows day after day. And now he is the legendary host of the EO Fire podcast. And he's traveling all the way from Puerto Rico to Tulsa, Oklahoma, to attend the in-person June 27th and 28th Thrive Time Show, 2-day interactive business workshop. If you're out there today, folks, you've ever wanted to grow a podcast, a broadcast, you want to improve your marketing, if you've ever wanted to improve your marketing, your branding, if you've ever wanted to increase your sales, you want to come to the 2-day interactive June 27th and 28th Thrive Time Show business workshop featuring Tim Tebow, Michael Levine, John Lee Dumas, and countless big-time, super successful entrepreneurs. It's going to be life-changing. Get your tickets right now at thrivetimeshow.com. James, what website is that?
thrivetimeshow.com.
James, one more time before enthusiasm.
thrivetimeshow.com.
Shining, everything rides on tonight. Even if I got 3 strikes, I'ma go for it. This moment, we own it. I'm not to be played with, because it could get dangerous. See these people I ride with. This moment, we own it.
Thrive Time Show 2-day interactive business workshops are the world's highest rated and most reviewed business workshops, because we teach you what you need to know to grow.
You can learn the proven 13-point business systems that Dr. Zellner and I have used over and over to start and grow successful companies. I mean, we get into the specific steps on what you need to do to optimize your website. We're going to teach you how to fix your conversion rate. We're going to teach you how to do a social media marketing campaign that works. How do you raise capital? How do you get a small business loan? We teach you everything you need to know here during a two-day, 15-hour workshop. It's all here for you. You work every day in your business, but for 2 days you can escape and work on your business and build these proven systems so now you can have a successful company that will produce both the time freedom and the financial freedom that you deserve. You're going to leave energized, motivated, but you're also going to leave empowered. The reason why I've built these workshops is because as an entrepreneur, I always wish that I had this. And because there wasn't anything like this, I would go to these motivational seminars, no money down, real estate, Ponzi scheme, get motivated seminars, and they would never teach me anything. It was like you went there and you paid for the big chocolate Easter bunny, but inside of it, it was a hollow nothingness. And I wanted the knowledge, and they're like, oh, but we'll teach you the knowledge after our next workshop. And the great thing is we have nothing to upsell. At every workshop, we teach you what you need to know. There's no one in the back of the room trying to sell you some next big get-rich-quick, walk-on-hot-coals product. It's literally, we teach you the brass tacks, the specific stuff that you need to know to learn how to start and grow a business. And I encourage you to not believe what I'm saying, and I want you to Google the Z66 Auto Auction. I want you to Google Elephant in the Room. Look at Robert Zellner and Associates. Look them up and say, are they successful because they're geniuses, or are they successful because they have a proven system? When you do that research, you will discover that the same systems that we use in our own business can be used in your business. Come to Tulsa, book a ticket, and I guarantee you it's going to be the best business workshop ever, and we'll even give you your money back if you don't love it. We've built this facility for you, and we're excited to see you.
And now you may be thinking, what does it actually cost to attend an in-person two-day interactive Thrive Time Show business workshop? Well, good news. The tickets are $250 or whatever price that you can afford. What? Yes, they're $250 or whatever price you can afford. I grew up without money, and I know what it's like to live without money. So if you're out there today and you want to attend our in-person two-day interactive business workshop, all you got to do is go to thrivetimeshow.com to request those tickets. And if you can't afford $250, we have scholarship pricing available to make it affordable for you.
I learned at the Academy, Kings Point in New York, acta non verba. Watch what a person does, not what they say.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. Robert Kiyosaki, the Rich Dad Radio Show. Today I'm broadcasting from Phoenix, Arizona, not Scottsdale, Arizona. They're close, but they're completely different worlds. And we have a special guest today. Definition of intelligence is, if you agree with me, you're intelligent. And so this gentleman is very intelligent. I've done his show before also, but very seldom do you find somebody who lines up on all counts. And it's a Mr. Clay Clark. He's a friend of a good friend, Eric Trump. But we're also talking about money, bricks, and how screwed up the world can get in a few and a half hour. So Clay Clark is a very intelligent man. And there's so many ways we could take this thing. But I thought, since you and Eric are close, Trump, what were you saying about what Trump can't, what Donald, who's my age, and I can say or cannot say?
I have to honor you, sir. I want to show you what I did to one of your books here. There's a guy by the name of Jeremy Thorne, who was my boss at the time. I was 19 years old, working at Faith Highway. I had a job at Applebee's, Target, and DirecTV. And he said, have you read this book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad? And I said, no. And my father, may he rest in peace, he didn't know these financial principles. So I started reading all of your books and really devouring your books. And I went from being an employee to self-employed to the business owner to the investor. And I owe a lot of that to you. And I just wanted to take a moment to tell you thank you so much for allowing me to achieve success. And then I'll tell you all about Eric Trump. But I just want to tell you thank you, sir, for changing my life.
But not only that, Clay, you know, thank you, but you've become an influencer. You know, more than anything else, you've evolved into an influencer where your word has more and more power. So that's why I congratulate you on becoming. Because as you know, there's a lot of fake influencers out there too, or bad influencers.
Yeah.
So anyway, I'm glad you and I agree so much. And thanks for reading my books.
Yeah.
That's the greatest thrill for me today. Not a thrill, but recognition is when people, young men especially, come up and say, I read your book, changed my life, I'm doing this, I'm doing this, I'm doing this.
I learned at the Academy, Kings Point in New York, acta non verba. Watch what a person does, not what they say.
Whoa. Hey, I'm Ryan Wimpy. I'm originally from Tulsa, born and raised here. I went to a small private liberal arts college and got a degree in business, and I didn't learn anything like they're teaching here. I didn't learn linear workflows. I learned stuff that I'm not using, and I haven't been using for the last 9 years. So what they're teaching here is actually way better than what I got at business school. And I went what was actually ranked as a very good business school. The linear workflow for us in getting everything out on paper and documented is really important. Like we have workflows that are kind of all over the place, so having linear workflow and seeing that mapped out on multiple different boards is pretty awesome. That's really helpful for me. The atmosphere here is awesome. I definitely just stared at the walls figuring out how to make my facility look like this place. This place rocks. It's invigorating. The walls are super, it's just very cool. The atmosphere is cool. The people are nice. It's a pretty cool place to be. Very good learning atmosphere. I literally want to model it and steal everything that's here at this facility and basically create it just on our business side.
Once I saw what they were doing, I knew I had to get here at the conference. This is probably the best conference or seminar I've ever been to in over 30 years in business.
You're not bored. You're awake, alive the whole time. It's not pushy. They don't try to sell you a bunch of things.
I was looking to learn how to just get control of my life, my schedule, and just get control of the business.
Planning your time, breaking it all down, making time for the F6 in your life, and just really implementing it and sticking with the program.
It's really lively. They're pretty friendly, helpful, and very welcoming.
I attended a conference a couple months back, and it was really the best business conference I've ever attended.
At the workshop, I learned a lot about time management, really prioritizing what's the most important.
Biggest takeaways are, you want to take a step-by-step approach to your business. Whether it's marketing, what are those three marketing tools that you want to use, to human resources.
Some of the most successful people and successful businesses in this town, their owners were here today because they wanted to know more from Clay, and I found that to be kind of fascinating.
The most valuable thing that I've learned is diligence, that businesses don't change overnight. It takes time and effort, and you gotta go through the ups and downs of getting it to where you wanna go.
He actually gives you the roadmap out. I was stuck, didn't know what to do, and he gave me the roadmap out step by step.
We've set up systems in the business that make my life much easier, allow me some time freedom.
Here you can ask any question you want, they guarantee it'll be answered.
This conference like motivates me and also give me a lot of knowledge and tools.
It's up to you to do this. Everybody can do these things. There's stuff that everybody knows, but if you don't do it, nobody else can do it for you.
I can see the marketing working. And it's just an approach that makes sense.
Probably the most notable thing is just the income increase that we've had.
Everyone's super fun. It's super motivating. I've been here before, but I'm back again because it motivates me.
Your competition's going to come eventually or try to pick up these tactics. So if you don't, somebody else will.
I'm Rachel with Tip Top Canine, and we just want to give a huge thank you to Clay and Vanessa Clark.
Hey guys, I'm Ryan with Tip Top Canine. Just want to say a big thank you to Thrive 15. Thank you to Make Your Life Epic. We love you guys, we appreciate you, and really just appreciate how far you've taken us.
This is our old house, right? This is where we used to live 2 years ago. This is our old neighborhood. See? It's nice, right?
So this is my old van and our old school marketing, and this is our old team. And by team, I mean it's me and another guy.
This is our new house with our new neighborhood.
This is our new van with our new marketing. And this is our new team. We went from 4 to 14, and I took this beautiful photo. We worked with several different business coaches in the past,
and they were all about helping Ryan sell better and just teaching sales, which is awesome, but Ryan is a really great salesman. So we didn't need that. We needed somebody to help us get everything that was in his head out into systems, into manuals and scripts, and actually build a team. So now that we have systems in place, we've gone from 1 to 10 locations in only a year.
In October 2016, we grossed 13 grand for the whole month. Right now it's 2018, the month of October. It's only the 22nd. We've already grossed a little over 50 grand for the whole month, and we still have time to go. We're just thankful for you, thankful for Thrive and your mentorship, and we're really thankful that you guys have helped us to grow a business that we run now instead of the business running us. Just thank you, thank you, thank you, times a thousand.
So we really just want to thank you, Clay, and thank you, Vanessa, for everything you've done, everything you've helped us with. We love you guys.
If you decide to not attend the Thrive Time Workshop, you're missing out on a great opportunity.
The atmosphere of Clay's office is very lively. You can feel the energy as soon as you walk through the door, and it really got me and my team very excited.
If you decide not to come, you're missing out on an opportunity to grow your business, bottom line.
Love the environment. I love the way that Clay presents and teaches. It's a way that not only allows me to comprehend what's going on, but he explains it in a way to where it just makes sense.
The SEO optimization, branding, marketing, I've learned more in the last 2 days than I have the entire 4 years of college.
The most valuable thing that I've learned, marketing is key. Marketing is everything.
Making sure that you're branded accurately and clearly.
How to grow a business using Google reviews, and then just how to optimize our name through our website also.
Helpful with a lot of marketing, search engine optimization, helping us really rank high in Google.
The biggest thing I needed to learn was how to build my foundation, how to systemize everything and optimize everything, build my SEO.
How to become more organized. More efficient.
How to make sure the business is really there to serve me as opposed to me constantly being there for the business.
New ways of advertising my business as well as recruiting new employees.
Group interviews, number one. Before we felt like we were held hostage by our employees. Group interviews has completely eliminated that because you're able to really find the people that would really be the best fit.
Hands on how to hire people, how to deal with human resources, a lot about marketing and overall just how to structure the business, how it works for me, and also then how that can translate into working better for my clients.
The valuable thing I've learned here is time management.
I like the 1 hour of doing your business is real critical if I'm going to grow and change.
Clay really teaches you how to navigate through those things and not only find freedom, but find your purpose in your business and find the purposes for all those other people that directly affect your business as well.
Everybody.
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 Everyone needs to attend the conference because you get an opportunity to see that it's real.